ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಕನ್ನಡ ಡ್ರೈ ಸ್ಪಾಕ್ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪುನೀತ್ ಭಾರದ್ವಾಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾವಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಹೊಸೂರಿನ ಟಿವಿಎಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಒಬ್ಬರು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ನ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅವರು ಅನಿರುದ್ಧ ಹಲ್ದರ್ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ವೈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಟಿವಿಎಸ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಇವತ್ತು ಅವರು ಒಂದು ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡಿರುವ ಟಿವಿಎಸ್ ಜುಪಿಟರ್ 125 ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹಲವಾರು ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ನ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಈ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅವರಿಂದನೇ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಗಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮುಂಚೆ ಒಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ಲೇಮರ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಬಟ್ ಈ ಕನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್ ನ ಒಂದು ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂನ ಕೊನೆದಾಗಿ ನಾನೊಂದು ಸಿನಾಪ್ಸಿಸ್ ಆಗಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಇವಾಗ ಈ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ನ ಶುರು ಮಾಡೋಣ ಸರ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಚಾನೆಲ್ starting with the first question and before I start with the question hearty congratulations it's a very beautiful product
thank you
Jupiter has always been one of the benchmark brands for TVS coming up with a 125cc and you know increasing the portfolio it definitely is something new for the people who are looking at a scooter market and definitely something new for us and exciting for us as well to test ride it and starting my question so we have been noticing TVS going forward with the push of 125cc segment Jupiter as a brand has been present in TVS portfolio for a long time may I know why is the push that is currently done on the 125cc segment from TVS
thank you for the question I'm glad that you're excited by the ride and we are very excited to bring the Jupiter 125 to you. Jupiter, as you said, is one of the most powerful automotive brands born in the last decade. Now we notice that across the industry, one in five buyers are looking for a 125cc commuter scooter. So if you look at a sporty scooter, we have the TVS Ntorq.
Correct.
But we are looking for a commuter scooter and that was a segment TVS was not in earlier. Which is where the Jupiter 125 comes in. Staying true to the entire philosophy of Jupiter, we have packed it with lots of loads and loads of exciting features, which we'll talk about soon.
Awesome, awesome. I'm certainly excited about this product. As I told you earlier, my next question is, as you told me that there is a Ntorq 125 for the people who are looking for a sporty scooter. And there is a Jupiter which is launched now in the same segment as I call it. May I know what is the difference that TVS wants to make between the Ntorq 125 and the Jupiter 125 in terms of customer
sure.
and also in terms of product portfolio?
Sure. So the TVS Ntorq is designed for a young Gen Z consumer who is looking for a very thrilling ride. Whereas the Jupiter 125 is a very premium, practical, aspirational offering. Which places a lot of emphasis on mileage, which places a lot of emphasis on performance on the traffic conditions. One of the most important differences that we made here is that we realized that the commuter scooter has to be bigger and better in many dimensions. So one is the style and you look, it's easy on the eyes. Second is that it's the only scooter in the segment that is able to offer you a two helmet storage with the largest under seat storage of 33 liters. We were able to do that because we moved the fuel tank from the back to the front, which also allowed us to give you a fuel filling in the front, which is another convenience feature. That mated to our all new 125cc two-valve engine gives you best-in-class mileage with the best-in-class initial acceleration. So in all terms, this fulfills the need of a commuter buyer today and very distinct in character, in ride experience from the TVS Ntorq.
Very well put together, sir. Definitely, TVS knows their customers, and that's the reason the Jupiter 125 is here. Sir, I noticed that you also emphasized on this scooter being fuel efficient. May I know what is the fuel efficiency figures when it's compared to its main rivals in the segment?
So, what we have done on the Jupiter 125 is that to take away all the mystery around the mileage number. We provide a gauge which gives you instant fuel efficiency. Okay. So it's not about me claiming a number, it's about you riding and you will be able to see the mileage that the scooter is giving you instantaneously. Now mileage is something that is very dependent on how you ride, how long do you idle, how fast do you ride, what traffic conditions are you in. But at all points in time, the Jupiter 125 gives you what your mileage is right then and it also comes with the indicator of the eco and power mode to help you guide to get more mileage out of your scooter.
Yes.
So it's conditioned from an engine perspective, from the gauge perspective, and also to help you get more mileage out of the scooter.
So certainly what you're telling is we have the technology and it's totally up to the rider how they ride and extract maximum efficiency from the scooter. TVS has ensured that it's engineered well and give a lot of feedback to the rider so that the fuel efficiency also increases. Yes.
Right? And it delivers the best in class fuel efficiency for its segment under any ride condition, but to maximize it, it has been aided for the rider to really take it up in real world conditions, the best mileage that any 125 can offer today.
Great, sir. I also noticed in your previous reply that you have given, the TVS has given the largest underseat storage in the segment. One, you told, you gave a sneak peek that you have moved the fuel tank to a different location. May I know what, how this was achieved? Because certainly for me, if I'm looking for a commuter scooter, this double storage of dual helmets certainly is a eye candy for me. I would definitely, that would be a sale right there. So may I know how TVS, I mean, I know TVS has done in the past, they have come up with amazing engineering aspects over their products, but I'm certainly keen to know about this one.
Sure. So our understanding with our consumer said that they needed a few things apart from the mileage performance and the sheer ride comfort. The space and demand, because this is a scooter that is for somebody who is, you know, buying into at a certain life stage where there is an aspiration, there is a certain size of family. The requirement then becomes about a much larger underseat storage. The requirement becomes about a longer seat. The requirement then becomes about being able to conveniently do fuel filling, whether it is the gentleman or the lady of the house doing it. So using that, when we moved the fuel fill to the floorboard, because we have an all new chassis in this, we were able to create a cradle on the chassis which could hold the all metal fuel tank, so completely safe, but move its location, creating a huge amount of space in the under seat storage area, creating space for two helmets. Also, because you created that large space, you were able to overlay it with the longest seat in the category, and because you moved it to the front, you are also now able to provide a front fuel filling option, which becomes even more convenient for all our users.
So what TVS has done here is they went with an agenda of creating a largest storage space, under seat storage space, and they have created a long seat and they have created a convenient fuel filling technology and all other engineering aspect, on also ensured that there is a metal fuel tank.
Yes.
So that safety is also absolutely taken care of.
Absolutely. And completely led by consumers. I think we have just ensured that we listen hard and listen long, and it has been our consumers who have guided us on this path.
Absolutely. So that's always when brand listens to their consumers and implement a product, it's different. It's definitely a very good feel, because I myself is a TVS owner. I own the NTorq. So when the brand I own do some stuff and they listen to the consumer, it's definitely a very good feeling that we get.
Thank you.
On that note, sir, you also spoke about the ideal, you know, you've listened to the consumers. May I know what, according to you, is an ideal consumer for the Jupiter 125?
So if you look at the Jupiter 110, right, there is a quintessential family scooter. And this was right 8 years back, it is right even today. But over the years, there's also been the emergence of a certain movement up, a certain progression in the life of the Jupiter consumer. And they have moved up to the next life stage. They moved up to the next level of success. They moved up to the next level of expectations from the vehicle. And for that reason, we believe that we needed to also create a progression in the offering of the Jupiter. So we have the Jupiter 110 and we also have the Jupiter 125, so that we are able to address the widest berth of commuter consumers.
Absolutely. Having choices, who doesn't love it?
Yeah.
Sir, my last question is, Jupiter, as you told, Jupiter 125 is a perfect balance between the consumer who is looking for a commuter segment, and also it is loaded with features. It's just that I found it very interesting when looking at the power figures of the scooter. I wanted to ask you one question. May I know what TVS preferred on the development of Jupiter 125 when they're doing it? Was it, where was efficiency on the list and where was performance on the list?
I think they go hand in hand, and I think that's one of the most difficult engineering challenges to break. I mean, where you want acceleration and you also want mileage. So again, I think going back to the consumer, we realize that from the acceleration perspective, it is the initial acceleration when you're getting off the red light, when you're in the low and mid range, where you need the maximum amount of acceleration. So if you look at a top curve, it is higher than any competitor in the low and mid end, and then it's a smooth curve. Smooth curve, you don't get a wavy kind of a performance. You get a very smooth ride through the thing. So that is in the low and mid range, and pairing that with a very intense focus through IntelliGo and ETFI, they have ensured that the completely new engine also delivers the best in class mileage.
Yes, so that's one point that I liked. It comes with the ISG integrated start motor and also auto start stop features, which will help enhance the fuel efficiency and also adds for convenience as well.
Absolutely.
Sir, my last request is, can you tell our viewers what they should be thinking when they look at the Jupiter 125?
If you're looking for a premium, safe commuting scooter to keep your family comfortable, go out for exhilarating rides, take on the traffic on an everyday basis, there is nothing like the Jupiter 125 out there that can do the job. So it's the best 125 commuter scooter out there for you, and that's all that they need to think about.
That's certainly well put together from the man himself. So iga neevu nodidre namma interview ee ondu product bagge. Definitely, idu TVS in the 125cc segment ke yav tara ondu commuter segment ke bekagiro scooter yav tara features en bekagirutte adanna sameta adanna mind alli ittkondu consumers na feedback tagondu TVS avaru adanna work maadi ಈ ಸ್ಕೂಟರ್ನ ಬಿಡುಗಡೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇದು ಒಂದು 125 ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ 125 ಸ್ಕೂಟರ್ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ನಾನಾಗಲೇ ನಿಮಗೆ ಈ ವಿಡಿಯೋನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಅವರು ಅಂಡರ್ ಸೀಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ನ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೂಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಮತ್ತು ಜುಪಿಟರ್ 125 ಸ್ಕೂಟರ್ನ ನೋಡಿ ಏನಿಸ್ತು ಅಂತ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಈ ವಿಡಿಯೋನ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ರೈಸ್ ಪಾಕ್ ಚಾನಲ್ಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಮುಂದಿನ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗೋಣ. ಸ್ಟೇ ಸೇಫ್, ರೈಡ್ ಸೇಫ್.